Kalangala district is found in Lake Victoria on the side of Uganda. Kalangala district comprises of about 60 islands which are inhabited. Bugala Island, where this project is located, is the biggest. The island measures about 30,000 hectares.
I went to school on this very island, but the way it was back in the 70s, it was just forest, grasslands, and the main activity then was fishing. But when the fish stocks dwindled from the lake, the government, together with the private sector and donors, introduced this project. This is the main island road. It was a little village road, but now you can see it's a very nice road. Plus, you can see the electricity lines. All these have come along because people have income.
In a nutshell, the 11,000 hectares of oil palm has caused a very big change.
Government started in way back 1970s to do the trial version on the oil palm project. That's where on the bidding process, they're chosen as the ideal partner is Bidco. We call it in 4-piece project. It is a public-private people project. The main objective of this project is a poverty elevation. Kalangala is one of the poorest and remotest district in this country. They started with the roads development, ferries transportation improved, there is a power project came in, and now it is everywhere in the power in the island, and there is a drinking water supply. Today is one of the most successful projects. Is the government, they call it is the role model project on the public and private partnership.
I am the general manager for the Kalangala Oil Palm Growers Trust. On behalf of government, we support the smallholder farmers working with a private company.
Farmer we're gonna meet today, Mr. Constantino Subuga. One of those farmers who initially was skeptical about this whole enterprise. But later on, through trainings, sensitizations, he picked up.
I love my work very, very much. I like farming. I take this project as my office. Every day, I wake up around 5 a.m. I say my prayers. Then exactly at 6, I start to do the work. Gender balance is very, very important. Where, remember, man, you can't be successful unless you have a wife. So my wife, she has got 5 acres. As a family, we have 45 acres in different stages.
Why I decided this one to be my main business, because every end of the month, I get money.
When you leave this one,
you leave money.
You leave money, please.
Okay.
This is my salary.
I'm even better than a government employee. Civil servants, they can take 2 months or 3 without getting their salary. But mine, it is not the same. As soon as I take my FFB to the factory, at the end of the month, I get my money. I've managed to take my children to school. Four daughters, they have graduated. Another boy is a banker. Another one is an auditor. My wife, she's a teacher. I'm proud of my family. I do all life. When I kneel down, I just say prayers to God. I thank God.
Martin, where we are going to right now, is the chairperson of the Farmers Association.
Around 1993, when they brought in trial plants, I volunteered with about 20 other volunteers. The plant had to be looked after for 3 years before starting producing.
Oil palm is a long-term project. Once you start revenue, it is a perennial income. It gives you 22 years. It was difficult to convince them to get into the board.
We had some slow start with the project. They thought that the project was too generous to be true. It funded farmers right from bush clearing up to production level. Every project has its ups and downs. But most of these bad words have been coming from those linked with environment.
Today in this island, about 6,500 hectares forest reserves, all are intact. If some timber cutting or charcoal burning is going on, is our people is the first to inform to the local authorities.
The time we started harvesting, that is when people started realizing that the project was real and the influx of so many new farmers came in.
It's now the beginning of the rain season, but it's good for the palm trees. We are gonna see a farmer called Samuel.
When I first met him and his family, I looked at a person who had very little hope. Today, he is a totally different man.
Kubanga chali chonona obutonde nekisera ekyo maso ekyakalangala ekyo chali suubi netwa tuliawo mu 12 mwena gagugwakawo amawulire negajja agaduza mu suubi ova mu kitongole ekyebyobulimi mu Uganda mufunze naffe twayingira mu kulima ebinazi kubanga ensimbi zaitu banga gavumenti ezo kula okutandika okutema fetu yekolera ne family yange ngaba kozi mu nimiro omu kati ezensimbi nezifuko musala era sako makwecho mukugenda nga nkungula nyongere okugaziya nimiro ekiyala twekola mu ekibiina ekyokutereka n'okwewola era tekyaliyo mulimi waffe wano akaba school fees omwana nti oba bulwadde bwe tulwala tusobola okugenda mu ddwaliro tuba tulonzeewo nga tetugenze nti no.
We support the farmers. We want also them to grow with us. We do the seedling supplies, we do the technical know-how, we provide them the market for the fruit. It is like a complete value chain from the soil to the pan, from the starting of the tree planting to extract the oil, to refine it and pack it in consumable pack and reach to the consumers. It's a whole value chain process.
Predominantly as a culture here, the girl children, the women were not so much involved or included in commercialized production chain. But here you find this project that is completely different. About 35% of the benefiting farmers are female. For example, Tabitha, a lady beneficiary farmer. She's a widow, but looks after a number of orphans. She used to live in a very old house, but now she has a permanent house, which is about complete.
You can see that there is really a great change because I can buy soap, I can buy salt. I have now stopped buying paraffin, I've got solar. If any man comes, I say, please, I'm now a woman of my own. Don't you think I'm now empowered? Sometimes it causes me to... We are given seedlings. Then we dig a hole 1.5 feet. Then we put there some little manure, cover it. So it goes on growing. After 3 years, it begins flowering. You have got to be patient. But these people were giving us a loan for maintaining it up to the harvest period. So that's why we were able to sustain this project. It has changed our lives one by one and the district as a whole. Now you can see people planting tomatoes, passion fruits, some work in the factories, some work in the oil palm, some have come to work on the road. There's a lot of development because of this oil palm. A woman can get money, and with that money, there is an increase in education. Those children, they were formerly remaining in the forest to keep monkeys from the garden.
Hey, now, go to school.
And God blesses me. So that's an achievement. Don't you see?
I feel myself so proud that, you know, along with my work, I'm part of the people here. I seen the people are, you know, growing, and it is a very great experience. I'm the luckiest person, I would say that.
I'm a youth. So to me, I'm very happy to see that we are growing from poverty to prosperity. We have work. So even these young people, when they look at a palm, they see that there is progress.
Auntie, Mubutoba touch you soon, Birakari. Kula, Ojono Nichiro to Chogova, Katachis in Zilanimidimu, Jokola, Jikuchusa, Kuaka Katimulimunemuna, Aroza, Tinangi Nanijuzi Motoka. Niatanga Tali maybe Nazi, Katanza Kujifuna, Atanga Gumoji.
The other days, we had just one worker here for the people. They used to know fishing only. Now they are lucky, because even if fishes are not there, these days people got another work.
It is amazing, from little villages, jungles, to good roads, communication network, bigger infrastructure, electricity, a clean water supply. The ferries and the ships are moving, and it's easy to connect to the mainland. As a person who saw it all when I was a little boy, moving along the village path with no hope that this place would be transformed the way it is. When I look at the changes you see today, I feel so good about it.
Is one of the biggest towns who do fishing in Ghana. So if you come here, you can see our canoes. That's what we use to look after our wives, children, schooling. We have about 600 to 800 canoes here. We do go at 12 a.m. in the evening. Then early morning, like 7 a.m., we return back with our catch. This is where we land our canoes. And this shed is where we sell our fish. The women will come and sell the fish too. They will store the fish in their freezers. When the dunso comes, our business gets rotten. Some years ago, Ghana is facing with a lot of electricity challenge. They cannot purchase the iceberg. And if you are able to get, it's very expensive, because the company that will provide you iceberg is using a big generator, which consumes a lot of fuel. So they are afraid if they buy a lot of fish, they cannot get a place to store, because they don't have iceberg to store the fish, to sell it later. So fear came. Both the fisher folks and the fishmongers.
At the peak of the crisis, some people could go without lives for close to 48 hours. Some people had lives for just 12 hours and then 24 hours off, and some even beyond 24 hours. People were having difficult times. People without lives couldn't do a lot of things. And so it negatively affected people both economically and socially.
My name is Paula Brokwa, and I'm from the Eastern Region in Ghana. I schooled in Kumasi at KNUST, that's Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, where I read petrochemical engineering. During those times I was in school, you'd be doing an assignment before you realize all the lights are out, there is total darkness, and you wouldn't have any other thing to do than to just go back to sleep. So it was very terrible. It wasn't good at all.
Ghana was experiencing an extreme power shortage, and they needed electricity yesterday. What we were able to do is to bring a very low-cost solution to Ghana until they go into longer-term sustainable generation to supply all their country. Karpowership is a floating power plant that can serve any electricity needs from short-term to long-term with the highest efficiencies in a most economic way and the fastest delivery times.
I was told that a ship will come, so we're also monitoring. They say on the radio, the ship is coming, now it's reached this waters, this country. So we are monitoring. When the ship got to Togo, Nigeria, we were informed that now, by 6 hours' time, the ship will be in Ghana waters.
Oh, well, Mufia Monami share. I can't believe what people what you are. Welcome. Mufia Moni Nake Agbaleleke Babo me. Mufia Moye Aranile Utoina. Lele Kashibini Akemashuju, but then we'll find what you are. Fekusunisa. Yeah, in Shona.
Karpowership is a subsidiary of Karadeniz Holdings that has been established in 1948. Since then, we have built 9 power ships, floating power plants, that are operating in 5 different countries around the world. It's delivered as a ready power plant, plug and play, to operate and deliver electricity within days after its delivery.
So we all line up at this area. Everybody switch on his phone. We start to capture the ship. I have it on my phone. It's big.
I never expected it to be that big. We saw it on the outside. Oh, it looked like a house. Yeah, that's how you say it. It looked like some apartments. I was amazed because it's actually a new technology. We didn't know about that. We always saw the land-based power plants, but this was new.
So we were all happy when we saw the ship. That so what? Well, mean, how can we generate power? What is it going to use coal or thermite? The sea, we thermite it. What? Think about it.
There was so much skepticism when the barge arrived. Some people predicted that the barge was not going to work because it would appear that to put power generation on a barge was a novelty. We were used to the conventional way of putting the plants. Onshore and eventually transmitting the power. But to transmit power right from a ship or a barge, it sounded quite novel and people weren't used to it.
My boss actually recommended me to Karpowership, then I applied, I came for the interview and I had the job. During the orientation, I realized like there were big structures, there were real units in there. I'd read about them, but I hadn't seen them before, so It was amazing. The whole feeling was like everything that you've read is now so real. I was living a dream. That day, that was how it looked. I was living a dream, walking into that Karpowership.
My name is Gürhan Ten. I'm plant manager of this Karpowership. I manage everything here from supply, from the kitchen, to the power supply to outside. The length of the vessel is 142 meters and the breadth is 42 meters. The height, including funnel top, is 60 meters. The barges have 3 sections. Forward side is equipped with 6 engines. The back side is as well with 6 engine. And in the middle of the power plant, there is an accommodation area, including food facility, dining facility, recreation room, and including control room as well. This is the control room where we are operating all the engine as an automation system. And this is our CCTV monitoring. And at right side, there is some control panel for our engine. You can see the numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we have one touchpad screen. You can control all your engine when you are outside of the plant. We can see all the data, everything regarding generator and power production, transmission on this screen from outside.
I work as a chemist on this ship, and what I do basically is to ensure water quality pertaining to fresh water generators, boilers, the steam turbine, and closed cooling systems that we have on the barge. I got in and I realized I was the only lady who would be working on the ship. There are two other ladies on there, but they do administrative work. So I realized I was the only engineer who would have to team up with the guys to work. Well, there, I had to embrace it. It was a challenge. I had to embrace it.
One of the challenges we faced as a country, we have the generation in stock, but we don't have the fuel available to power them. They source their own fuel. So the most important thing is for them to deliver the power to us.
We have 12 engines on our plant, which is producing a power engine, natural gas as well, including one steam turbine to give us much efficient power, because the cost is almost nearly nothing for us, because we are producing a steam from exhaust gas, and the steam is used in the steam turbine to give us power to grid system.
Now we needed to get power from the ship into the national interconnected transmission systems. That required the construction of transmission lines. And what Bidco did was to team up with Karpower to construct an 8-kilometer transmission line from the port to our nearest substation.
Since the Karpowership came in, it has had constant, we have had constant supply from the Karpowership. So it's given stability to the power system.
But so far, the barge has generated more than it has even been contracted to generate. And so it tells me that sometimes it's worth taking the risk, and that if you listen to some pessimistic views, you may not make a positive dent as far as the socioeconomic development of the country is concerned.
The fishermen in Tema are our hosts. We are like a guest at their house, and we respect that fact very much, because they have been there for the hundreds of years, earning their bread from the same waters that we're operating in.
In this community, you have experienced light of when the ship arrived. Now, everybody's living very well. Now, if you see people, if everybody's laughing, now everybody's enlarging its business now, because nobody's thinking that this will come again.
What we are able to achieve in Ghana is more than just supply of electricity. It's a partnership between the country, the people, us, and the utilities. So what we are able to provide them is with base load electricity running 24/7, reducing their average cost of electricity, and in the meantime, making sure that all the community is benefiting.
I have some t-shirts that I wear from home to work, and on the first to work, sometimes when you are going, you just hear people saying behind you, Karpower, Karpower. They are proud of us, and they didn't expect that Karpower would take on local personnel. So they see us and they are happy, oh, at least Karpower has come and it's provided employment opportunities for our local people as well.
When they put everything on night, it's going to look beautiful. We all cherish that. That's how our community look like. People come here at night, just come and look. People from afar, far, far, far places to come and witness how the ship look like, because we haven't heard about ship can generate power.